In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess
to Almighty God,
and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, in what I have failed to do.
Through my most grievous fault.
Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints,
and you, my brothers and sisters,
to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. As we recall year by year the mysteries by which, through the restoration of its original dignity, human nature has received the hope of rising again, we earnestly beseech your mercy, Lord, that what we celebrate in faith, we may possess in unending love. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. The high priest rose up and all his companions, that is, the party of the Sadducees, and filled with jealousy, laid hands upon the apostles and put them in the public jail. But during the night the angel of the Lord opened the doors to the prison, led them out, and said, "Go and take your place in the temple area, and tell the people everything about this life." When they heard this, they went to the temple early in the morning and taught. When the high priest and his companions arrived, they convened the Sanhedrin, the full senate of the children of Israel, and sent to the jail to have them brought in. But the court officers who went did not find them in the prison, so they came back and reported, "We found the jail securely locked and the guards stationed outside the doors, but when we opened them, we found no one inside." When the captain of the temple guard and the chief priests heard this report, they were at a loss about them, as to what this would come to. Then someone came in and reported to them, "The men whom you put in prison are in the temple, and they are teaching the people." Then the captain and the court officers went and brought them, but without force, because they were afraid of being stoned by the people. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord hears the cry of the poor.
The Lord hears the cry of the poor.
I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall be ever in my mouth. Let my soul glory in the Lord. The lowly will hear me and be glad.
The Lord hears the cry of the poor.
Glorify the Lord with me. Let us together extol his name. I sought the Lord, and he answered me and delivered me from all my fears. The Lord hears the cry of the poor. Look to him that you may be radiant with joy, and your faces may not blush with shame. When the poor one called out, the Lord heard, and from all his distress he saved him. The Lord hears the cry of the poor. The angel of the Lord encamps around those who fear him and delivers them. Taste and see how good the Lord is. Bless the man who takes refuge in him. The Lord hears the cry of the poor. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, so that everyone who believes in him might have eternal life.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
God so loved the world that he gave us his only begotten Son, so that everyone who believes in him might not perish, but might have eternal life. For God did not send his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world might be saved through him. Whoever believes in him will not be condemned, but whoever does not believe has already been condemned, because he has not believed in the name of the only begotten Son of God. And this is the verdict, that the light came into the world, but people preferred darkness to light because their works were evil. For everyone who does wicked things hates the light and does not come toward the light, so that his works might not be exposed. But whoever lives the truth comes to the light, so that his works may be clearly seen as done in God. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
So I want to reassure all of you of our continuing prayers. The sisters and I are constantly interceding on behalf of the beautiful communities of J. Sarah Catholic High School, St. Anne, and St. John the Baptist. I want to also remember the repose of the soul of Jean Hawk Beakey, the grandmother of Mrs. Abdullah, who passed recently, so we pray for her eternal repose. I'm very apt to remind everyone at every homily that we have an entire Easter season culminating on Pentecost Sunday, and I believe that's May 31st this year, so may we always go forth rejoicing in God's good news. And this is perhaps one of those more commonly quoted verses in Scripture, John 3:16, which is, God so loved the world that he gave us his only begotten Son. And it's important because of the fact that God wants to have compassion and empathy for us. That's why he took on human flesh. And the best way that he was able to show us of his love is that he chose to demonstrate or manifest that through suffering. Okay, not exactly everyone's favorite word, through suffering in the cross, but that oftentimes is the best way for us to show one another that we love one another, being able to commiserate and to suffer with one another. Compassion. Cum patior in Latin, which means to suffer with. And I
recognize that I'm no longer in the classroom to the same degree as our sisters or as to all of you out there who are laboring in the vineyard of the Lord, going and learning new technology and so forth. And I know the sisters already are very versed in technology and so forth, but I've had teachers, and I shared this with you before, sort of commiserating these days where they have to learn new things and so forth. And one in particular shared with me that, you know, she had to learn like Google Classroom, is that what it is, and how to post things. And in a moment of perhaps I wasn't so compassionate in this moment where I said, well, it's not like tomorrow you have to invade France. Okay, you're not landing in Normandy tomorrow, nor are you going and performing brain surgery. And at that moment, she kind of reminded me that, Father, it's good to in moments to just keep quiet and to listen, okay? To listen. So I've learned, or not really truly have learned, that as a priest, sometimes when people tell you their problems, it's good to just be quiet and to listen. And that's the best way to show empathy. And I want to encourage all of you in these days ahead when people may be stressed, our students are stressed with exams and so forth, it's good to just put yourself in their shoes, to listen, and to the best way to listen would be to bring their petitions and intentions along with your own and to bring it to prayer. So silence is always a beautiful thing. I always appreciate moments where I'm alone so that I can elevate my mind and my heart to God. And the best way to do that would be to attend Mass. Even if we are not there physically, it's good to make full use of all the Masses out there. I feel like a lot of the priests are now learning technology by learning how to live stream or to record their Masses and then to make them available. And I encourage all of you in your respective community, whatever parish you belong to, whatever church you belong to make full use of that, because we do not want to let this beautiful season pass us by without taking full advantage of God's love and mercy for us. And being that Divine Mercy Sunday, although behind us, we are always given God's mercy. It is as vast as the ocean. So your sins and mine, once again, are but a small, tiny little pebble, and we want to always bring that and throw it into the vast ocean of God's mercy, and it will be completely absorbed. Nothing that you and I can do at times when it is not so good will ever hinder God's love for us. So we want to make sure that we remove those obstacles, not only during the Lenten season, but throughout our entire earthly pilgrimage. So as we traverse through this earthly pilgrimage, this earthly sojourn, please always avail yourself to God's mercy, because he sent us his son, right? He so loved the world that he gave us his only begotten son, Jesus Christ, to suffer and die for us in order to show us empathy and compassion.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
O God, who by the wonderful exchange effected in this sacrifice, have made us partakers of the one supreme Godhead, grant, we pray, that as we have come to know your truth, we may make it ours by a worthy way of life, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation at all times, to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to laud you yet more gloriously when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. Through him, the children of light rise to eternal life, and the halls of the heavenly kingdom are thrown open to the faithful, for his death is our ransom from death, and in his rising, the life of all has risen. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic host sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Kevin, our Bishop, Timothy and Tom, his assistant bishops, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who please you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
Let us pray.
Graciously be present to your people, we pray, O Lord, and lead those you have imbued with heavenly mysteries to pass from former ways to newness of life, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended. Alleluia.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia.
Saint Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our defense
against the snares of the devil.
May God rebuke him, we humbly pray.
And to thou, Prince of the Heavenly Host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all evil spirits, who prowl about the world, seeking the ruin of souls.
Lord Jesus Christ, shepherd of souls, who called the apostles to be fishers of men, raise up apostles in your holy church, particularly to our Dominican Institute. Teach them that to serve you is to reign, to possess you is to possess all things. Kill in the young hearts of our people the fire of zeal for souls. Make them eager to spread your kingdom upon earth. Grant them courage to follow you, who are the way, the truth, and the life, who lives and reigns forever and ever.